running back. Stand up, or you're going to get lit. Stand up.
What you just saw is a brief snippet of a father of a victim in the Parkland mass shooting who lost his son, Manuel Oliver, being arrested, being brutalized in that particular way because he committed the crime of interfering with a Second Amendment related hearing that was ongoing. So Manuel Oliver ended up getting barred from the place and then driven to the ground. And we don't know exactly what immediately led up to it. That's the only video that we have. But we do know is that he wasn't the only member of his family who was treated incredibly poorly by the Republicans managing this hearing. Patricia Oliver also ended up getting hauled out of the room. Take a look at this.
When I decide to be a mom, I am a mom all the way. I don't need BS from anyone.
Officers.
Yeah, so look, the chairman Fallon said he didn't know who was speaking when he said, I believe the words were remove that woman, which really sums up, I think, right wing politics in the modern era. But the idea that there would be no empathy remaining from these Republicans for these two parents who've gone through an unimaginable tragedy. I don't know how, as the parent of someone who died in one of these shootings, you can sustain years of activism which hold the hope of reform, but also are a constant reminder of the worst thing to ever happen to you and your family. And so the fact that they persist years later and receive so little assistance, so little, just common decency, it just sucks. And this is, by the way, this is a hearing about guns. It's the quote, ATF's assault on the Second Amendment, when is enough enough? So even when you can finally get a hearing on guns under the Republicans, it's about how the ATF is being unfair. Right, what do you think?
It's not a hearing. The way that they labeled the hearing means they're not there to hear it from you. And if
it's
you-
It's a speaking.
It's a speaking, it's just stupid. It's just a nothing. And when someone tried to make it a something, that person was pushed to the ground and arrested violently. This stuff happens all the time, by the way, in the halls of Congress and in any place. Someone comes in at the back and it says something and then they have to be taken out because, order in the court. And the people, typically Republicans in these situations when they're having hearings about gun safety, that they are bigger victims than the people that the folks in the back shouting are trying to give a voice to who died in a place where there should have been safety as well, their school. And it is insane to me that in this current environment, the right wing thinks that the biggest victims is them and the biggest culprit is books, when really the biggest threat to the safety of children in our schools is firearms. And when folks try to, in a good faith effort, get protections for people in a place that should be sacred and safe, the Republicans literally call it government overreach from the jump before they have a chance to hear anything.
Yeah, by the way, it really does feel like, hypocrisy doesn't matter as much as I think it should. I don't know what your position on Ben is, never cared about it. He thinks it's very natural, and I get it. He's been following politics for longer than me. But if you're gonna have, for instance, like a movement against cancel culture, and then you immediately pivot to banning books and banning entire topics and banning being able to reference that Rosa Parks is black or whatever, it feels like that should be like fatal hypocrisy. If you're going to have a movement which the slogan is save the kids and it's all about protecting the children, and you flee at even the mention of the thing that's killing the kids, that should be fatal hypocrisy. And maybe it is. I mean, the fact that Republicans can't win national elections and so many of their most radical candidates, especially at the Senate level, lost, maybe, outside of places like Florida, it is fatal. It just like, it can't be said enough how little they actually care about the substance of the things that they talk the most about.
Yeah.
Any other thoughts, Brett, for him?
I think that, the Donald Trump, whether he created it or crystallized it, more than anyone, just didn't do the thing that everybody else was kind of goaded into doing, which is apologize or acknowledge wrongdoing. Mm-hmm. Talking past the hypocrisy. Now, staying on message has always been something you do in politics, but talking past the hypocrisy, pretending it doesn't happen, and not apologizing and actually going after people who are rightly accusing you of wrongdoing, that's a new thing. And he got away with it. And so everybody else is trying to as well.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.